good morning to all of you and welcome in our science session.
So we are discussing our lesson and the name of the lesson is what? Motion and measurement of distances. Okay, so in this lesson already we have discussed about the sum points, and today we'll move for the next point, that is what? Measurement of length. Okay, so how to measure the length? Before going to see that how we are going to measure the length, which type of the instruments we are using the length, let's discuss about what is mean by length. So length is the distance between any two points or places. Okay, so the distance between any two points or place is called a length. See here I have drawn one point and another point I will draw here. Okay, so if you want to measure the distance between these, then what we are measuring? We are measuring the length. Okay, so here what we can say, that the distance between the two points or distance between any two places. Okay, in this way what if we are measuring that, then what we are measuring? We are measuring the length. Okay, so the length is the distance between any two objects or any two point or any two places. Okay, so to measure that length, as we know, the SI unit of length is what? Meter. Okay, so let's see with the help of the meter or with the help of that SI unit how we can measure the length. Okay, so whenever we are measuring the width, breadth, height, thickness, that time what we are measuring? We are measuring the length. So thickness, width, breadth, height, all these are the nothing but what? Measurement of length. All these things whenever we are measuring, then we are measuring the length. And to measure that length, we are using the different types of the instruments. We are using the different types of the tape, like that you can see in the image. We can use the different types of the tape, like that flexible tape we can use, which is used by the mason or the civil engineer. Also the one type of the tape is there, that is called as what? A flexible tape is there, but which is used by what? Tailor. Okay, also we can see that, see, this is the scale. This scale also we can use for the measure. Here is also one more scale, then this scale is also we can use for the measurement. Okay, so in this way there are so many different instruments we can use to measure the length as per our convenient required. Okay, so to measure the things, we can use a different type of the instrument as per the convenient for the required purpose. Okay, so let's see how to measure the length of small distances. Okay, so to measure small length or short distances, how to measure the small length or short distances? I am having this pencil. So if you want to measure the length of this pencil, then it will be in the centimeter. Okay, it will be less than meter. So it is inconvenient to measure the length of this pencil in a meter. So this length of the pencil is less in than meter. So it is inconvenient to measure, to express the length of this object or the length of this pencil in a meter. So to measure the length of this pencil, we can use the centimeter. We can use the unit, that is what? Centimeter. Okay, so see here, 1 meter is equal to 100 centimeter. Okay, so whenever we are measuring the 1 meter, it means what? How many centimeter? 100 centimeter we are measuring. Okay, so the 1 meter is equal to 100 centimeter. Next one is the 1 centimeter is equal to 10 millimeter. Okay, so see here, there are the certain objects which are very small. Okay, if you want to measure the thickness of this coin, see here I am having this coin. If you want to measure the thickness of this coin, then it is inconvenient to express the thickness of that coin in the centimeter. So that is the reason we can measure the thickness of this coin in millimeter. We can measure the thickness of this coin in a millimeter, means the very small object, the very small length or the short distance we can measure in a millimeter. Okay, so see here, 1 centimeter is equal to 10 millimeter, while 1 meter is equal to 1000 millimeter. Okay, so all these are centimeter and the millimeter, these are the units that we can use to measure the small length or short distances. Okay, these are the things that we can use to measure the small length or short distances. Okay, again I will repeat, 1 meter is equal to 100 centimeter, while 1 centimeter is equal to 10 millimeter, and 1 meter is equal to 1000 millimeter. Okay, but there are the certain objects, there are the certain places which are so far away from each other. For example, we can say that if we want to measure the distance from Khed to Ratnagiri, then we cannot measure the distance into the centimeter or into the millimeter or the meter. It is inconvenient to measure the distance in the meter or the centimeter or the millimeter. So, to measure the distance of a long, okay, to measure the large length or the long distance, we are using the another unit, that is nothing but what? Kilometer. Okay, so the large distance or the large length or long distance, it is convenient to measure in a kilometer. Okay, so the large distances we can measure in a kilometer. So see here, 1 kilometer is equal to 1000 meters. 1 kilometer is equal to what? 1000 meters. Okay. So all these numbers you have to keep in the mind that we are going to use for the conversion. Okay, conversion purpose all these things are required. Okay, so these are the units for the short distance or the small length, and the kilometer is the unit that we are using for the large length or long distance. But see here, we are writing the units. So to while writing the units, there are the certain precautions that we have to take, or there are the certain rules that we have to follow whenever we are writing the units. Symbols are not followed by full stop. Okay, means after the symbol, see here I have written the centimeter. After the symbol, there should be not full stop. After the symbol, there should be not full stop. Symbols are not written in a plural form. Now plural form means what? See here, centimeters, we cannot write this. Okay, only we have to write the centimeter. Meter. Okay, so this symbol should will not get followed by the plural. Okay, or we cannot write the units into the plural form. You have to just write the suppose it is 100 centimeters, then here we cannot write like this 100 centimeters. No, then it is wrong. We have to write only 100 centimeter. Okay, we have to write only 100 centimeter. Okay. Next one is there, that is symbols for units are written in small letters. Okay, symbols of units are written always in a small letter. See here, everywhere we are using the small letters, means we cannot denotate the symbols with the help of the capital letters. All every time whenever we are writing the symbol, we have to use the small letters. Okay, so these are the three main rules that we have to use whenever we are writing the units. First one is what? There should be not full stop after the symbol. Symbol, we cannot write the symbols in a plural form. And next one is that symbol should be written in a small letter.
This is the time to tell you goodbye. We will meet in the next video with the next point I've got today. Thank you.